Have you ever tried to send money across borders? Let me give you something real. Years ago, I ran a small business importing products from China. And every single time I had to make a payment overseas, it was the same painful process. I'd wire money through the banking system, and then I'd wait 5, sometimes 7 days before it landed. And by the time it finally showed up, I had lost thousands in fees and currency differences. Now, it always struck me strange because at the very same time, I could pull out my phone and I could send a text across the world instantly. I could FaceTime someone in Beijing in seconds. But if I wanted to send money, suddenly I was back in the financial stone age. Now, I want to be clear. I'm not a financial advisor. I'm not here to give you investment advice. What I am here to do is to share what I've learned over more than a decade of studying our financial system and the emerging world of digital assets. I've also had the privilege of interviewing regulators, policymakers, technologists, and industry leaders from around the globe. And through all of that, I discovered something critical. The biggest problem with money today isn't that it's just slow. It's full of friction. Here's what I mean. Every time money moves across borders, it doesn't travel in a straight line. It drags through a long chain of middlemen, banks, correspondent banks, clearing houses, and every step takes time. And every step skims off a fee. That's one reason why the international businesses hold giant amounts of money trapped in bank accounts all over the world, just to keep the wheels turning. So here's where the breakthrough is happening. New technology is beginning to remove that friction by building what are called on-chain systems, which are digital rails for money. We can finally start to move value the way we already move information. On-chain systems like Bitcoin, XRP, stablecoins, are creating digital rails for money, allowing value to move globally and instantly, just like information does on the internet. This is what people mean when they talk about tokenization. Tokenization simply means taking something of value like money, stocks, real estate, even music rights, and representing it digitally, so it can move across the internet just like an email. Now, if that sounds futuristic, think about how the internet itself began. It didn't start with cat videos and streaming. It started with protocols. TCP/IP lets computers talk to each other. SMTP made email possible. HTTPS gave us websites. And together, this gives us the internet of information. Today, new protocols are being written for money itself, and that's what people are calling the Internet of Value. And just like the Internet didn't simply speed up the mail, but transformed entire industries, the Internet of Value could reshape everything we can do with money. Families sending remittances won't have to watch a week's worth of groceries disappear in fees. Small businesses won't be stuck waiting days for payments to clear. And massive sums of capital frozen in bank accounts could finally be unlocked to fuel economies around the world. This isn't science fiction. Governments and central banks are already experimenting with digital currencies. Legislators are working on rules to support this innovation and technologies, just like they did in the internet in the 1990s. The Internet of Value isn't going to arrive someday in the distant future. It's unfolding right now, quietly in the background of our daily lives. If you look back through history, every major leap in human progress has come from stronger, faster connections. The printing press connected us with knowledge. The telegraph connected us with communication. The internet connected us with information. And now, blockchain and digital assets are connecting us with value itself. So think back to the story of me trying to send money overseas. waiting a week, losing thousands in the process. That story won't even make sense to kids a few years from now. Just like we laugh about dial-up internet today, they'll laugh at the idea of moving money used to take days and ate us up in fees. And someday, people will look back and ask, where were you when money finally caught up to the digital economy? Where were you when the internet of value was born? And I'll tell you where I was. I was standing right here with you, sharing this transformation, because the future isn't something far down the road, waiting to arrive someday. I believe the future is already here. Thank you.